Sedin on the other side of the ice takes this draw against Fisher and wins it. Spezza. Tried to get one across in the neutral zone. That was blocked. Oh, that hit Lonnie Cameron in the head as Watson tried to dump the puck in. And think it was Helmut. But concern for the linesman, and out comes John Sanderson being guided by Nikita Tramkin to check on Lonnie Cameron.
Lonnie is down. Oof, just turned sideways almost.
Towards the ear.
Side of the head for sure. Watson was just trying to clear it in. And
Lonnie Cameron back on his feet, but headed to the Canucks medical room to be further checked out. And this game will continue on with three officials for the time being.
With the players, jump onto the charter afterwards and head back home after a five-game road trip. Actually, 5-0, and that caught the linesman. He's in trouble.
Oh, yeah. No, right away. And it caught him right in the leg. He didn't see it after he dropped the puck.
That's Steve Miller.
He's a real good guy, too, in the league, a veteran linesman. And he sees it coming, tries to get out of the way, and, oh, right off the knee. Oh, boy. Right on the kneecap.
Play it back in, and it's over to Gaudreau. Johnny Gaudreau, here's Berlin. Hit the post. How did that stay out? Then the puck went off the side of the referee's head. And that'll draw a whistle as that clips referee TJ Luxmore. Michael Ferland had a wide open net. And looked like he was certain to get a second of the game, and then the shot hit the post and right off the noggin of the referee Luxmore, and hopefully he's all right. You can see he's cut there on the ear.
Oh boy, that hurts too. Anytime you get any sort of blow by the ear, takes me back to my days as a kid every once in a while playing sports, and that is nasty.
Especially if you're outside on a cold day playing.
Oh boy. Yeah, what a setup though. This is very close to being offside. Just wait and wait and wait. Stalock bit completely on that feed. Beautiful pass once again from Johnny Gaudreau.
Past the midpoint of this first period. Talbot moving well, got the puck in. It was knocked down with a high stick, but Talbot then plays it deeper into the Pittsburgh zone, so play carrying on.
That's Mike Civic. As the players got bigger, so did the linesmen, and so did the referees. Mike Civic just happens to be 6'9". Timber! Right there, as Mike Civic, as he gets up on the boards to try to avoid that hit by Max Talbot, well, he takes a little tumble into the bench.
Couldn't handle a bouncing puck. Coyle had to leave the zone. Now Hanzel has it deflected off a linesman's skate. He's able to hold on. Puck caught the linesman up high.
He got him right up.
Down quickly.
Caught him up, and I think he's bleeding. He caught that puck up in the face, and Hanzel was just trying to chip that puck in as he was being pressured at the blue line. He tried to keep the puck in after it hit the linesman's skate. He's being pressured, so he whips it, and it catches the linesman up, looked like in the cheek area. Did have a visor on, but the angle that puck came up, it caught him right up, and it looked like in the cheek area.
The zone time, I think just not doing all those little things. They've got to stick to their script. They got away from it. They've got to get it back.
Alex Ovechkin maneuvers down the wing. There's a linesman behind the play injured.
Yes, man.
Linesman down and ailing.
His left knee. He can't even get up. He tried to get up and couldn't.
It's linesman Steve Barton who is in need of attention.
Moved away. Watch him sort of nudge into Foligno. Maybe he doesn't. Yeah, right there. With that leg, and that throws everything off, and watch the twist of the knee there. Ugh. Oh, that's what he's conferring with to see if that can be made here and making sure it's okay to do that if that's indeed the case.
They've stabilized that leg as fans inside of Capital One Arena, the players as well, wishing well to the fallen linesman, Steve Barton.
Played this way by Brian Allen. Back of the goal, Chandler Rose for Carolina. Holding on to it, and play is blown dead and injured official in the corner. of our referees tonight, Kelly Sutherland. Seems to be okay as he gets back up. Oh my goodness. Yeah, he's bleeding a lot. I didn't see what happened. It was in the far corner. I'm not sure if it was a stick or the puck. I assumed the puck.
Well, watch the left part of your screen. There you see the stick of Mike Weber catch Kelly Sutherland right above the brow. He got a little bit of, he might have got glued up there, and he's back on the ice. So quick repairs. Wow. Big round of applause there for the Buffalo Sabres medical staff.
Raquel brings it back out to center ice. Passes to Boschman. Jared Bull just off the bench, can't control the puck. He takes a hit. Long pass to Gaudreau, had to duck. That was head high, and it winds up being an icing call on Calgary with 7:53 to go in the first period of play.
Linesman Brian Murphy knocked into the Flames bench. And we'll have to keep our eye on him because Murphy got up and went into the other end and fell over here, tripped. So, I don't know if he has an upper body issue.
That pass was into the skates of Jonathan Drouin. Gensel is hit hard right in front of the Pittsburgh bench and into the linesman. That is Steve Miller who got tangled up there with Gensel.
He may have a concussion from that.
Jeez.
Coming down with so much speed, and he chips the puck past the linesman, and the linesman does a good job of trying to get out of the way of the puck, and as he's focusing on that, I mean, Gensel just runs right into him. And it's an unfortunate thing. There's the chip, and the puck hits the linesman, and as Byron gives Gensel a shove, there's just nowhere for the linesman to go. I mean, he's in this position to make sure the play stays onside properly, and right there is the collision. It looks like Gensel's going to be okay, and linesman Steve Miller's up.
He's got 22 goals on the season, and right. Connor McDavid gets his 61st assist. He was jumped there by Horitsky, and the linesman went down in that pile.
It's an ugly spill, too.
And it is Steve Barton.
Connor streaking up, chips it off. Horitsky trips Connor, knocks him down, and you see Steve Barton just, oh boy, that is... That's hurt right there. Watch Steve's head hit the ice. He can't protect himself. Bang. That's a neck and head. That's ugly right there. And you can see that he is right away in some major league pain. TD Force out to help him. That's not good to see.
A helmet, a huge part of protecting Steve in that situation, but they are still bringing the stretcher out to attend.
They'll probably brace him up here, Kev, and just you have to take every precaution on a neck injury. And it's great to see that you've got such a qualified Oilers medical staff helping out medical attention, and they'll take care of Steve down there right now. But it's nasty, nasty. Thank you.